This episode was proudly made possible by the all-new 2015 Subaru Legacy. It's not just a sedan, it's a Subaru.
Embryonic stem cells are a huge next step for medicine, but they're mired in controversy. So, what if you could have all the benefits of regenerative medicine without the thorny moral dilemma? Hello, science lovers. I'm Julian here for DNews. There's been a huge breakthrough in medicine this week. Induced pluripotent stem cells were used in the tissue transplant for the first time ever. We did it! Yeah! I'm gonna have to explain all that, aren't I? Okay. First, let's get everybody up to speed on stem cells. This is more important to you than you realize because you were at some point nothing more than 50 to 150 of them. You probably don't remember, it was only 4 days after you were conceived. Now, what makes embryonic stem cells amazing is that they are pluripotent, meaning they can become almost any type of cell. This means they can be used to replace damaged tissue and may one day be an alternative to organ transplants. Now, this is huge. In the United States, an average of 79 people receive an organ transplant every day, but another 18 people die waiting for a transplant that'll never come. The 79 who do get a donor will have to take medication to prevent transplant rejection for the rest of their lives, but even then, the risk remains. The problem doesn't exist with embryonic stem cells, though. So, we can save thousands of people a year and improve the quality of life and lifespan of tens of thousands more. What's the problem here? Well, the only way to get pluripotent cells is from embryos, which are pre-people. Or current people, depending on where you stand on the issue. Obviously, there's a heated controversy there, and I'm sure the comments will reflect that. Be nice, guys. Now, umbilical cord blood has multipotent stem cells, but they're more limited. And we all have adult stem cells, but those are even less versatile. So there are no alternatives, until now. Shinya Yamanaka of Kyoto University discovered a method to create pluripotent stem cells from adult cells. It's like diet stem cells, all of the flavor with none of the calories. Though in this case, flavor means life-changing benefits and calories means severe moral dilemma of using undeveloped humans in medicine. And for his breakthrough, Yamanaka shared the Nobel Prize for Physiology in 2012. And now, here we are, September 2014, where on Friday at 2:20 local time, Japanese doctors stopped the macular degeneration of a 7-year-old woman by transplanting a sheet of retinopigmented epithelium cells derived from induced pluripotent stem cells made from the reprogrammed cells of the patient's own skin. We did it! Probably. Now we wait and see if the procedure checks the macular degeneration without becoming cancerous or rejected. By the way, that sheet of tissue used was just 3 by 1.3 millimeters. It's about that big, and what a huge step that is. If you'd like to learn more about how your eye works and why the macula is important to vision, check out this video. As a bonus, you can stare deep into Trace's dreamy, dreamy eyes. Can you think of any creative potential uses for induced pluripotent stem cells? Wolverine. Well, let us know in the comments. Hopefully it stems productive discussion. Remember to subscribe for the latest in science, and I'll see you next time on DNews.